This is Business Analytics Using Forecasting, and I'm Galit Shmueli. I'm excited today to talk to Mrs. Leo, who's a board member on the YouBike company. We're very lucky today to have a new station here at Tsinghua University, and Mrs. Leo was kind enough to answer some really interesting questions about their data and how they can use it. Mrs. Leo, can you please tell us, you have so much about every bike and every trip that it takes. How do you use this data to forecast or do something with this data?
We use this rental and the returning points data. We analyze the usage, the needs of each station, and then we redistribute our bicycles to different stations. So basically, we use this data for our management and for our service. But if for the official departments, like our transportation department, if they need more data to do more analysis or more study, we open our data like 6 months ago, the old data, for them to do the study and the analysis. But basically, the data for our management is for redistribution and reschedule. For the department, for the transportation department, is another data. And then they open those data to our schools, to our association. So it's very convenient and very open.
So this data is used by the transportation department to link to trains, buses?
Yes, they could do that. Actually, I'm not sure how they use it, but we open this data to the transportation department, and then they decide how to use it or how to analyze it.
Yeah. Okay. And how about, I know that I have an app that uses YouBike.
Yes.
How do those apps, what kind of data do they have?
Those data is the number of the dock and the number of bikes on each station. So and it's renewed every minute. So any association in Taiwan or in the world, they could get the information every minute from the website. It's open. It's open to everyone. So anyone can use it.
Wonderful. And I guess one question is, there's some similar YouBike facilities in other cities in the world, and they link themselves to a card that also has information about the rider. Typically, they'll know something about the gender, if it's a male or female, and maybe their age, something like that. Does YouBike also have some information about the riders?
Basically, at the registration, no. We don't have those information because we use easy card. And the iPass card in Taiwan is our transportation department, transportation card. Those are our transportation card. And it's not registered. So you just get the card, you deposit money in it, and you can use it everywhere. So we only register the user's mobile phone number. But the mobile phone number could not tell us the genders or the age or the occupations, anything. That's, we don't know. So
would that be helpful if you had it?
Well, but I hope we have those data, but we don't.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wonderful. Mm. And I guess the last interesting point about YouBike data is that, like you said, it's useful to YouBike. It's also useful to government agencies.
Yes.
But in fact, now that we have some stations here at Tsinghua Dashui, this can be really useful to the university itself because we will learn about traffic of students, faculty coming in at different times of the day.
Yes.
So, for example, we can adjust the Tsinghua bus schedule, or we can adjust the air conditioning schedules.
Yes.
Do you think maybe collaborations like this between YouBike and facilities like that would be useful?
That would be very useful for the students, especially. Yes.
And it would also be very useful to students taking this course who can use the data and analyze it and use some forecasting.
Yes.
Wonderful.
That's right. Yes.
Thank you so much for telling us about the insides of YouBike.
Thank you. You are welcome. My pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.